What's up, guys? How you doing? Back with Legit. Stuck in traffic as usual. Nothing out of the ordinary there. Some water pipe has just burst, and so there's massive traffic jams everywhere. So I'm gonna try and get out of here ASAP. Cheers, bud. Anyway, guys, I hope you are all doing well. I don't know about you. I saw a video in the news about the Metropolitan Police. Now, I've seen quite a few vloggers. Sorry, mate, I didn't see you. My bad. Vloggers talking about this. And it's the use of tactical contact. Hello. How you doing? You don't look like a racy type, though. Regarding the use of tactical contact and moped thieves. Now, like, I've seen police chases. I've seen, you know, like cops instantly catch someone after they've done something, and I've been foolish enough to chase people before, which we won't go into now, that's time for another video. But I mean, there was this MP, don't know if you guys may have heard of her, especially if you're not from the UK, called Diane Abbott, and she is very, very much against police in like all respects. Even a simple arrest, she'll find a problem with it. And so She comments on this video that the Metropolitan Police posted of them using tactical contact to end pursuits of moped thieves. And she says, you know, officers shouldn't be allowed to do this. They're basically meant to uphold the law, not break it by knocking people off. But at the same time, these are guys that are knocking other riders off their bikes, that are stealing, you know, our mobile phones while they ride along the pavement and snatch it out of our hands. And they're the ones that do all these, you know, smash and grab operations on jewelers. And there's been like so many in the last year of these instances where they've been doing it. So I don't understand what Diane Abbott thinks we can do to stop these pursuits. I mean, you can't ask them nicely with polite little, like, words, oh, please, you know, please pull over, please don't hit any more pedestrians. You know, there was even a video of one of them hitting a uniformed police officer. I think it was a PTSO. But it just goes to show their lack of remorse, their lack of care, and their lack of, you know, a society, because they don't believe in any of that. They believe it's their way or the highway kind of thing. So hell, I totally agree with the Metropolitan Police on what they're doing. Of course, they're doing a great job. I just think it's sad that there's people in government like this Diane Abbott that are there sticking the thorn in the side, being the hindrance and making them drag their knees, because, you know, we all know that the police is short by, I think it's about 30,000 police officers. I think it's 20,000 actually, sorry. Short by 20,000 officers. And yeah, hell, that makes an impact on not just officers, but their morale. You know, if they're having to do two times the amount of work with half the amount of resources, that's a very high stress situation with people that, you know, are going to find themselves not wanting to do things, especially like chasing moped thieves, when you know, people like Diane Abbott say they need to be prosecuted, when, you know, Billy the Scroat comes and nicks a load of phones, 12 phones in a day, and the police knock him off his bike to stop the pursuit. There is nothing wrong with that. You know, if you're going to get injured by the police and you're in a moped pursuit, it's your fault for not stopping. If this was America, fucking hell, you know, it would be like, of course, like, what is wrong with you? The police are right. It's just in this country, there are some people who just do not have any common sense, who live in this ivory tower and a bubble and believe that, you know, just, I don't know, I think they just believe in magic, because this just astounds me that someone could think like that. But, you know, they got into power for a reason. I'm sure she's good at something that we will never know, but whatever. So what do you guys think? I'm going to show you some footage of what I'm talking about, and I want your opinion on it. What you think? I think it's justifiable. Hell yeah. I mean, you know, we stop cars that evade from police. Why not stop mopeds? Just because they're on two wheels instead of four doesn't mean, you know, they get any more leniency towards them. I don't think that should be the case at all. It's very unfair to the victims just to say, you know, these guys have used this means of transport just so they don't get caught after they've robbed you. You can't say that to a victim. You want to tell the victim, yeah, I've caught this person, man. That's what we all want to hear. Guys, could these officers do apart from knocking them off? Like, there's people that say, you know, just get the helicopter up and follow them back and, you know, call off the pursuit because it's dangerous for everyone around them. But yeah, I understand that. Of course it's dangerous and it puts other people's lives at risk. But you can't get the helicopter up every time there's a moped out who has committed a crime, you know. Otherwise, the helicopter, you'd need thousands of helicopters. You know, I want you guys, like I said, let me know what you think about this, what you think the police should be doing, and if you think there's any other tactics they could use, because, I mean, that would be great, right? If there was something else they could do that's not as dangerous, what do you think? So, in your opinion, does this mean the police are stepping up by, like, adopting these harsh tactics? Or do you think it's just because of all this, like, media outcry about all these thieves getting away from it? That they're now doing something about it? Do you think it's gone too far, or do you think it should go further and it hasn't gone far enough? See, in my opinion, I would like to see it go further. Not because I'm a horrible person, but because I've been a victim of theft. And I think our criminal justice system here in the UK is way too lenient with people and lets them get away with so much stuff, like prison sentences, suspended sentences. It's just a joke, man. People get charged with stuff, and it's just like, you know, there was that guy with the zombie knife. I don't know if you guys have seen that clip. I'll drop it in now. The guy with the zombie knife, you know, he's already been sentenced for having a bladed article and using it whilst robbing someone, and he goes out and does this, and his barrister in court says he was kidnapped by a gang and held hostage, right? So that's his excuse for having a zombie knife. So Was he kidnapped outside? Was he trying to break free from his captors at this point? No. He was out in the street. No one was stopping him. He was trying to smash into a car to stab someone up. You know, no one was holding a knife to him saying, you move, you die. He was doing all of his own actions. All he got was 150 hours community service. Mate, I hate when people wear their jackets like that. Just put it on properly, dude. 150 hours of community service. And, like, I think it was a couple of hundred quid fine. It's just a joke. Why shouldn't the police be doing harsher stuff to these guys? You know, we need to set a precedence before it just gets too out of control. And this car's going to come round and come on. But yeah, honestly, it's just fucking mental, this stuff that's going on. Anyway, guys, I'm looking forward to seeing what you think. Drop a comment down below. Like, subscribe, and check out my Amazon merch if you want to get into motorbike blogging and want to know what I use. Have a look at the stuff I use. It's all on Amazon. It's no more expensive than the price I pay for it. So have a look, help me out. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next one, guys. Take care.